Well, my next guest is a former Islamic extremist whose actions landed him in an Egyptian prison for about 4 years. He has since changed his ways and written a book. Maajid Nawaz is author of Radical, My Journey Out of Islamist Extremism, and he is also founding chairman of Quilliam, a globally active think tank focusing on issues like extremism and immigration. Maajid, thank you very much for being here. So your thoughts on President Obama's strategy?
Yes, Megan. I mean, I think I would endorse a lot of what we've just heard. Unfortunately, I don't think this current administration has had has this issue of Islamist extremism correct from day one. It's been from comparing them to the JV team, all the way through to allowing the red line to be crossed in Syria, all the way through to the situation we have today, where just a day before the France attacks, the president stated that ISIS is being contained in Iraq and Syria. The policy from day one has been a policy of obfuscation, denial, and unfortunately a lack of action and a lack of strategy. Now, I don't believe what we're facing, unlike what the Pope mentioned and what King Abdullah endorsed, I don't think we're facing World War III. On the contrary, actually, what I think we're facing is a global jihadist insurgency. And how an insurgency differs from a traditional war is that insurgencies, by definition, rely upon a certain level of support within the communities that they're seeking to recruit from. Mm-hmm. And as we know with ISIS, you know, 6,000 fighters have gone and joined the worst terrorist group that we've ever known in modern times from Europe. Now, that 6,000 doesn't appear in a vacuum. Those 6,000 weren't radicalized overnight. I'd go so far as to say ISIS didn't radicalize those 6,000 who joined them. ISIS plucked the low-hanging fruit. They were already radicalized.
But to those in the administration who would have us believe, oh, it's just it's a smattering of people. You know, they're based mostly in Syria and we're after them in Syria. What say you?
No, absolutely. It's incorrect. I mean, those 6,000 that joined ISIS in Europe, ISIS plucked the low-hanging fruit. And the reason they were already radicalized is because for decades in Europe, we have Islamist groups working within Muslim communities who have been busy radicalizing Muslims in Europe. I know I was one of those they radicalized. They've been proselytizing and preaching the idea or the notion of resurrecting a theocratic caliphate. So along come ISIS 10, 15 years later and declare that they've established this caliphate. People had already been primed and in anticipation for the return of this so-called caliphate. In surveys, 33% of British Muslims have sympathy for the notion of resurrecting a caliphate. So we're not looking at ISIS as the main problem. We're not
That's
even looking at this now
thing.
Defunct term that the State Department used to say.
Radical Islam. I want to talk to you about that because the president says, and his supporters, Hillary Clinton, we don't say radical Islam. It's just going to alienate mainstream Muslims. Your thoughts on that?
Well, I think actually, you know, there's a danger that if we don't name this thing Islamist extremism and isolate it from mainstream Muslims and then undermine it, on the contrary, exactly what the State Department is hoping to avoid will be brought about because, you know, when we don't name something, the vast majority of people that don't really understand these complex conversations will assume the problem is with the religion of Islam and Muslims themselves. It's only by naming it that we're able to isolate it from mainstream Muslims and say the problem isn't Islam. The problem is Muslim theocracy. The problem is Islamist extremism, those who wish to impose a version of Islam over society. Mm-hmm. Now, this idea that it's got nothing to do with Islam is as preposterous as saying it's got everything to do with Islam. The truth is, Megan, it's got something to do with Islam. That something mm-hmm. is the fact that Islam is being politicized. It has been for decades within our communities. And it's about time we recognize that, named the problem, isolated it from mainstream Muslims, and then all of us together, Muslims included, but everyone else as well, it's all of our responsibility to then go about challenging this ideology and undermining it.
I'll tell you what's extraordinary. Right here we have a former Islamic extremist making points, and the former head of the Defense Intelligence Agency is sitting right next to me, shaking his head in agreement. These two men are on the same page with respect to a lot of these points.
A violent agreement.
Violent agreement. Unbelievable point on which to end. Thank you both tonight so much.